Good morning, friends. So last class we have discussed about the current electricity till the drift velocity and mobility. Okay, drift velocity we have learned the formula Vd is equal to minus e tau by m. That is for the drift velocity. And another one thing we have learned is mobility mu. That mu is equal to Vd by e. So we don't need to worry about the minus. So e tau by m divided by e. So this e get cancelled. You'll be getting e tau by m. So that is for mobility. So two things we have learned. One is for drift velocity and another one is for mobility. Drift velocity e tau by m, and mobility the formula is written as e tau by m. So today we are going to discuss about two relations. Not two relations, few relations, okay na? The first relation is relation between current and drift velocity. I and drift velocity. So for that, let us take a conductor of length L, okay? This is the terminal A, this is the terminal B, connected with a battery. This is the positive, this is the negative terminal. Here the current I is coming. So the electric field will be acting towards this direction. And let me take an electron. The electron is drifted towards the negative terminal with a velocity Vd. Understood? So let us take, this is the surface area A. This is the length of the conductor L. Okay. Now, we know that formula for the current. What is the formula? I is equal to Q by T. The Q can be written as N E by T, where N is the total number of electrons. Capital N is nothing but the total number of electrons. Okay, but let us assume that small n, n is the number of electron per unit volume. Just let us assume that n is the number of electron per unit volume. Then the capital N will be n into volume. Correct, na? So we know that n, volume is nothing but area into length. So you will be getting N is equal to NaL. Take this as equation 1. This you take it as equation 2. Okay. Now just substitute 1 in equation 2. You will be getting I is equal to NaLe divided by T. But you know that L by T, L is nothing but length. T is nothing but distance. Length by distance, that is nothing but the velocity. So I can write this I is equal to N A V D into E. So this is the formula for the current. I is equal to N A V D E, where I is the current, N is the number of electron per unit volume, A is the area, Vd is the drift velocity, E is the charge of the electron. So this gives the relation between current and drift velocity. This indicates that current directly proportional to the drift velocity. Current is directly proportional to the drift velocity. So this is the first derivation. Hope you have understood. Next, let us move on to the next one, the next topic. The next topic is current density. Current density denoted by the letter J. So what is meant by current density? Current density means nothing but current by unit area. It's nothing but current by unit area. So current by unit area means the unit will be ampere by meter square. But already we have learned the relation for current. Current can be written as NAVDE divided by A. So this A and A get cancelled. So current density can be written as NVDE. So this is the formula for current density. J is equal to NVDE. Now there is a relation J and E, current density and electric field. There is a relation between current density and what? Electric field. So for that, first let me write J. J is equal to I by A. I can be written as what? That means this is equal to N VDE. From there we got it. Okay, NVDE. We know the formula for drift velocity. So what is drift velocity? EE tau by M into E. Understand? EE tau by M into E. So that can be written as N E E square tau M. That we can call it as the relation between J and E, where the J can be written as J is equal to N E square, N E E square tau by M. That you can take it as rho into, sorry, sigma into E. Already we have learned about sigma. What is mean by sigma? Sigma is nothing but conductivity. Sigma is nothing but what? Conductivity, where sigma is equal to N E square tau divided by M. Sigma is equal to N E square tau divided by M. So this is one way. There is one more way to denote what this thing. You know the formula according to the Ohm's law. V is equal to IR. V is equal to IR. So we know that V is equal to dl. So E into D. And D only here considers the length L. So you can write as V is equal to EL. And I, N A V D E divided by, or you can go with this thing da. Just you write as, we need to find out J. I, let me write as I. R alone you substitute, R is equal to rho L by A. So this L and this L get cancelled. Remaining what is there? E. E is equal to I by A. I by A can be written as J. J into rho. So J is equal to E divided by rho. You know that 1 by rho is equal to conductivity. So J is equal to sigma into E. J is equal to sigma into E. So this is also one more method. Either you can go with this method or you can go with this method. But this will be the easiest way. You can go either whatever one you can. Okay. So V is equal to IR. V can be written as EL. I can be written as I rho L by A. And this L and this L get cancelled and the remaining will be E is equal to J into rho. So J is equal to E by rho, or J is equal to 1 by rho. 1 by resistivity otherwise can be called as a conductivity. So J can be written as sigma into E. So this is the formula for conductivity. This is the formula for conductivity. Or this otherwise called as what? Microscopic form of Ohm's law. Or alternate form of what? Ohm's law. J is equal to sigma into E. Otherwise called as microscopic form of Ohm's law. So this is the second relation. So first we have learned the relation between drift velocity and the current electricity. Second we have learned the relation between current density and the electric field. The third relation now we are going to find out the relation between resistivity rho in terms of tau. Here tau, you know that tau is nothing but relaxation time in terms of tau. So for that also, let us start from the Ohm's law. V is equal to IR. Now V can be written as EL into I can be written as NA VDE, and R can be written as rho L by A. This A and A get cancelled. This L and L get cancelled. Remaining E is equal to N VDE into rho. Now substitute VD value. VD value, you know that N into E tau by M into E into rho. So here also E there. So this E and this E get cancelled. So then 1 is equal to N E square tau rho divided by M. So we need to find out rho. So rho is equal to M divided by N E square tau. So this is the formula for resistivity. This is the formula for resistivity. So resistivity can be written as rho is equal to M divided by N E square by tau. Then conductivity again, 1 by rho na, you will be getting N E square by tau by M. It resembles the previous result, already what we have learned. Sigma is equal to 1 by rho is equal to N E square. Similarly, the R can be written as R is equal to rho L by A. So that can be written as M divided by N E square tau into L by A. So this is another form of Ohm's law. So Ohm's law can also be written by this thing, ML divided by N square tau into A. So here this formula is very very important for numerical. The resistivity can be written as M is equal to rho is equal to M divided by N square into tau. Understood, madam? So these all the relation between resistivity in terms of I. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is nothing but resistor. So what is meant by resistor? Okay. So resistor means it is nothing but a component which offer resistance, or the conductor which offer resistance, that we can call as a resistor. It is denoted by the symbol. So you can able to find out this type of symbol on the roadside. This indicates what not a speed breaker. This also similar to what not the speed breaker. Okay. It is also similar to speed breaker because it reduces the speed of the electron. That is the reason the resistors are denoted by what not this symbol. This resistor can be classified into two categories. See? The resistor can be classified into two categories. One is wire wound resistor and another one is carbon resistor. One is wire wound resistor and another one is carbon resistor. Wire wound resistor means this will be there in the lab. You can able to find out what are two terminals here. Okay, across the terminals the wire will be wound. This you might have used in the 10th standard to find the relation between potential and current. That means verification of Ohm's law, you might have used this thing. It is available in the lab. Okay, it's wire wound resistor. It is only used in the laboratory. Second one is carbon resistor. It is used in electronic components. Okay, all the electronic components will have the carbon resistor. In the carbon resistor, you can find the value will not be printed over there, but the value can be represented by four lines. Here three lines and one more line will be there at the last one. These three lines gives the value of resistance. The fourth line gives the, there are four lines. The first three lines gives what not the value of the resistance, and the fourth line will explain about the tolerance. Okay, this you can take it as A, B, C, this you can take it as T. Tolerance. based on the lines only we can able to calculate the value of what carbon resistor. The main difference between the wire wound and carbon, the carbon resistors are made by carbon components. Wire wound resistor only used in what laboratories. The wire wound resistors made by two component, either manganese or constantine or nichrome. Okay, but mainly we'll be using what the manganese. The manganese is a material, it is an alloy, manganese. Okay, this all the threes are alloy only. These are used to make what not the wire wound resistor. But the carbon resistor is made by carbon components. It is made by what not nothing but the carbon components. And here you can able to find out what not the lines. The lines only used to find out the values of what not the resistors. The lines, by based on the lines, we can able to find out the values. There are so many color coding. This is otherwise colors or color coding. Okay. The color coding, there are so many lines. To simply remember this line, there is a word. See, B. B. Roy of Great Britain. Don't forget, B. B. Roy of Great Britain had very good wife wearing gold, silver ornaments. In the ornaments alone, you can take it as no. Okay, gold, silver, ornaments. See, B.B. Roy of Great Britain had very good wife wearing gold, silver, ornaments. The ornaments alone, you can take it as no. So, here, these till that white, you'll be using what not for this color coding, and the remaining these three things are used to find out the tolerance value. Okay. So, B.B. Roy of Great Britain had very good wife wearing gold, silver ornaments. Don't forget. This first B, black. Second B, brown. Third one, red. Fourth one, orange. Yellow. Gray. Blue, violet, this is green, this is gray, and finally white. This is gold line, this is silver, last one, no colors. Okay, see, again you may get a doubt that first one black or brown, so just keep your head. Okay, our head is which color? It's black in color. Okay, our palm is in which color? Leg palm, that is in white in color. So it starts from black and end with what not a white. So black, brown, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, then gray, white. So these lines are used to what not to find out the resistance value. And these three are find out what are tolerance, gold, silver, and no color. First, the D, black, the value will be 0, brown 1, red 2, orange 3, yellow 4, green 5, blue 6, violet 7, gray 8, and white 9. Again, gold 5%, silver 10%, and no color means 20%. These are used to find out what are the tolerance. These are used to find out tolerance. Okay, let me give some example. How do you calculate the color coding in the carbon resistor? For example, let us take a resistor. First three color here. This will be gold. First one, brown. Second one is orange. Third one is yellow. How do you calculate the? We are going to find out the resistance R, tolerance T, and the range resistance you are going to find out, the tolerance you are going to find out, and the range. What is the range? Okay, so first let us do that draw. Here first one you have to take it as A, second one will be B, third one will be C. The formula is equal to resistance R is equal to AB into 10 power C plus or minus T. T is nothing but the tolerance. R is equal to AB into 10 power C plus or minus T. First, let us take A. A for brown. Brown, what is the color? Number 1. So first one, you have to write the number as it is. Okay. Second, B. B is nothing but orange. Orange, what is the number? 3. So write 3. You should not multiply, just you have to write the number alone. 1, 3 into 10 power. Yellow. Yellow, what is the number? 4. So 13 into 10 power 4 plus or minus the tolerance. Gold. Gold, nothing but what? 5%. 13 into 10 power 4 plus or minus 5%. This is the value of resistance. How much is that? 13 into 10 power 4 plus or minus 5%. This is the value of what, na? That resistance. So you can able to find out the value now. 13 into 10 power 5. Now, we have find out the resistance. We have found out what, na, the tolerance. The next, we have to find out the range. Range means, this is nothing but 13 into 10 power 4 plus or minus 5%. First, we have to find out the 5% of this value. That means 13 into 5 by 100. So these two zeros, two zero cancel. So this value will be equal to 0, 0, 15, 6, 6, 5,000. 6,500, sorry. So now the range will be 30 into 30 minus 6,500 ohm to 6,500. Okay, that means the given resistor can able to withstand from this value to this value. Understood, nada? It can able to withstand the value between one another, this to this. That is the reason of this gold. If it is made of silver, means you are taking it as 10%, then instead of 6,500, you may get in 13,000. Correct, nada? You might have get 13,000. Then you have to take according to that. Understood, nada? So this is the range of the given value. Okay, let me give one more example. Let us check a resistor. 3, here no color. This is brown, black, green. Brown, black and green. And the tolerance will be nothing. So, let me take this as A, this as B, this as C. First A, brown. Brown, what is the number? 1. Then black. Black, what is the number? 0. C, green. Green, what is the number? 5. So, write that. Now, you know the formula for R. R is equal to, here, no color. No color means, that is nothing but how much? 20%. So R is equal to AB into 10 power C plus or minus tolerance. That is equal to A 1, B 0 into 10 power 5 plus or minus 20% ohm. That is the value of the resistance. So we could able to calculate the value of resistance by using this formula. The next, let us go to the combination of resistor. This is equivalent to what, the combination of capacitor, what we have learnt in the previous chapter. So now let us take combination of resistors. There are two types of combination. First one is series. Series combination. Assume that there are three resistors going to be connected in series with a battery. So this is the current I. This resistance R1, this is R2, this is R3, this is plus and this is minus. And you know that it's a series combination, so there is only one way for the current. There is no another way. So the current flowing through all the three resistors is constant. That never be changed. So current constant, then what will happen to the potential? Divided across here, the potential will be V1. Across here, the potential will be V2. Across here, the potential will be V3. And the equivalent resistance or the equivalent circuit is given V, this is R series. That means R equivalent is equal to RS. Here, we are going to use the Ohm's law. Ohm's law means the top you have to get from nada. E, here on I. So current is voltage is divided, so you have to take what not a V is equal to 1 plus V2 plus V3. That means take this as equation 1. Here you can take it as V is equal to I RS. Take this as equation 2. Now V1 is equal to I R1. V2 is equal to IR2, V3 will be equal to IR3, take this as equation 3. Now, substitute 2 and 3 in equation 1, then 1 becomes IRS is equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. So all the I get cancelled, then RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this is the formula for the combination of resistor in series combination. Okay, so now let us move on to the parallel combination. So this is for parallel combination. Parallel combination, the R equivalent will be equal to RP. And here, first one, second one, this is the potential V, this is the current I, R1, R2, R3, this is I1, I2, I3. Correct, na? So there R equivalent is equal to RP, but here I1 is equal to I2, I3. Here current has three different ways, but in the previous case current has only one way, but here current has three different ways. So the current can be divided. So this current, let me take it as I1, this is I2, and this will be I3. Sure, Nada? So now, what divider that you can take here? So I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Take this as equation 1. Here you can take it as I is equal to V by RP. Take this as equation 2. Now, I1 is equal to V by R1. Here potential will be constant as they are connected in parallel combination. I2 is equal to I2 is equal to V by R2 and I3 is equal to V by R3. Now take this as equation 3. Now substitute 3 and 2 in 1. What you will get? I is equal to V by RP is equal to V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3, all the V get cancelled. So what will get? 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay, if you want to take the LCM, you will be getting R1, R2, R3. Top you will be getting R2, R3 plus R1, R3 plus R1, R2. If you take the reciprocal, RP will be equal to R1, R2, R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. Understood? So this is the formula for the net resistance in the parallel combination. Suppose for n identical resistor, for identical, then RS will be equal to R plus R plus R dot 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 dot, that will be equal to NR. In parallel, 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R, that you can take it as N by R. So RP is equal to R by N, that you can take it as equation 2. Now equation 1 divided by equation 2, that means RS by RP is equal to NR divided by R by N. So this R get cancelled, it will go up. So N square by 1, that means RS is to RP is equal to N square is to 1. Don't forget, this is for identical resistors. Understood now? Thank you, students. Let us stop it and we will continue in the next class.